This is a message to all the anime companies within the anime community and in the anime industry regarding the West. Now, before I get onto this video, I do want to say that there is no maliciousness towards this video whatsoever. I do want to say I have all these manga volumes from Viz. I have an 8 to 10 year subscription with Crunchyroll, and I've got so many Blu-rays up there in regards to either Viz Media or Funimation or Manga Entertainment, etc, etc. So this is coming from someone who is generally speaking as a consumer, as a customer, and someone with some actual genuine concerns that I want to throw out there. So, with that being said, this is going to be a rant. So, please hear me out. Because I do know that people from Crunchyroll did watch my video back in 2018 in regards to High Guardian Spice. And this is kind of where I want to start my topic. Don't worry, Viz and Funimation, I'll get to you very shortly. Crunchyroll, let's talk about you first. One, good job on translations. I actually generally think that you actually do a generally good job at translations as far as that goes. And as well as being one of the main online platforms to license the majority of anime IPs, I think you do a fairly good job in that too. However, there is certain things which annoy me a lot. I also guess I should mention as well, there is a bit of personalness within this rant as well. So, you know, a lot of it is bias and a lot of it is general objective criticism. So there you go. I gave you the warning. First and foremost, in 2018, I made a video talking about High Guardian Spice, about why it shouldn't be released and why it is terrible and why people are actually angry about it. Besides the fact it looking like a cartoon and a Steven Universe kind of ripoff, let's actually talk about the nitty gritty of High Guardian Spice if you hadn't watched that video. I showcased the Crunchyroll's trailer, and High Guardian Spice's trailer, which didn't really show anything about the characters or the story at all, it really revolved itself around about who was working there, why it was important. Important that diversity is key, and why having a 100% female staff mattered, apparently, only to find out months later, or even weeks, I don't know the timeline, that the main writer for High Guardian Spice was an absolute, let's just say a man-hater. Would that be objectively correct? I would say so. You know, when you do a hashtag kill all men, I don't know if I would like my company to be associated with that, considering, you know, I'm a guy that's been in a lot of controversy. However, my occasional one or two fuck-ups is a bit, you know, lesser compared to 50 fuck-ups, or maybe 100, I don't know. What's out there? We'll never know. But still, I gave you the warning, and so did many other YouTubers that you, Crunchyroll, and Viz, and many other companies follow. So clearly, you must like them, right? And you must take their opinions into consideration, seeing as you guys follow them, such as, you know, the Anime Man, for example. That's a very popular one that you guys follow. Being another YouTuber that also complained about High Guardian Spice and the complete disassociation with its customers ever. So why is it that you are still continuing to drop this? Granted, it was originally supposed to come out in 2019, and good job on you. You actually cancelled the show for 3 years. You actually listened. I mean, the fact that you still kept up the trailer and disabled the comments and likes was a bit fishy in and of itself, but hey, you did a good job. You didn't give that show the time of day. Now, let's fast forward a few years later, and again, this is rumours because I don't know the absolute fact, but apparently Crunchyroll got attacked so much by the staff and the team that made the show that they pretty much twisted their arm into making it happen. And thus, we have 2021 High Guardian Spice, unfortunately being brought onto a Crunchyroll, which nobody asked for. Not a living, breathing specimen asked for this show. Your job, Crunchyroll, was to use half of our money to go towards you, to keep the service afloat and to pay the employers, and the other half to go support in the anime industry of the shows that we like. Have you kept that promise? No, you have not, because you wanted to keep up with Netflix originals and you decided to make your own stuff. Now, granted, if you want to be on the production committee of some studios from Japan, fair play all to you. Go support our favorite studios and whatnot to create what they want to create and, you know, put our money towards that. That was the point. And if you want to call it a Crunchyroll original, call it a Crunchyroll original. But what is that? Nobody asked for that. And the fact that you looked at that trailer and you thought it was acceptable to put online in the first place, and after the backlash that you got from it from your consumers, goes to tell me that you actually don't care about your consumers' opinions, which is important because the consumers are the only people keeping your company afloat. That being said, despite the fact that the main writer has a Twitter checkmark for whatever reason I do not know, and the fact that you are still supporting someone that literally said to kill all men. What? Like, I know you probably don't like me, or maybe you do. I'm not quite sure. Clearly not, seeing as I was blocked early today for, well, did I ask for, we'll get onto that in a minute. The fact of the matter is that you still advocate for someone that wants the death of all males. And is that a company I truly want to support? Not really. If it wasn't for anime streaming being the main contributor for animes being successful in this time of day, I would have gone to Kiss Anime and illegally watched my shows, because you are not a company that is doing the consumers justice, from my perspective. And doing a video is unfortunately the only way that maybe you might listen. I'm not being a dickhead. I'm actually being a very concerned consumer, because I will, you know, give you positives on any of the lights. I mean, why don't you use that money that you paid for that mid-ass show and actually put it into something creative, which you started to do? Oh wait, you did, but you copied me. Remember when I did Anime News Roundup for Viewster, and then shortly after, you copied me? Regardless of the fact that you may have copied me, and I know you watch my content, why aren't you continuing to do that? You want to put your money towards something creative, something cool, and something fresh? Do that. Why have you got to invest hundreds of thousands into a product that your customers literally told you not to do? So when it comes out tomorrow from the recording of this video, don't watch it. Don't support it. Because I do generally think these companies, especially Crunchyroll, need a hard reality check. Because if voices won't hit them, the fucking bank will. And maybe you really need a reality check, and maybe to be humbled a little bit on who actually support your site. Because we want anime. We paid to watch anime, not for you to make an originals to tell us we're wrong if we don't like it. Because last I checked, some of us watch the anime for the story and not because of the staff that are working on it. Most of us couldn't give less of a fuck who's working on it. But the moment you start dictating to us what we need and why we should give a fuck, and the creator telling probably 80% of Crunchyroll's audience who are male to kill themselves, I think at that point, sorry Crunchyroll, you've lost me, and I think you've insulted the majority of your fanbase by allowing such a specimen to fucking be allowed on your platform. I hate to say this, but I really hope it fails. And I really hope, you know, after 2018, I don't have malicious towards you, Crunchyroll, but I really hope you start listening to your consumers in the future. Now let's talk about Viz. Hi Viz, how you doing? Seeing as you don't like me, that's an absolute fact. Even though I've done so much for your company in promoting a series which you wasn't even promoting in the first place, and selling out your stock on Amazon with my fan base, good job to you guys. Not once did I ever get a thanks from you guys. You've never sent me review copies of any of your Bleach Blu-rays, except for maybe one. But then after that, you told me you don't ship to my country, which is bollocks, because I think you did it the first time. Whatever, to each their own. And considering you unfollowed me because 5 troll accounts told you to, yet you don't unfollow certain content creators which have literally sexually harassed people and got exposed for it. But hey, that's none of my provocative, right? I'm the arsehole here. So anyway, what have I got to say about Crunchyroll? Stop fucking censoring your translations. It's cringe. Seriously, who are you hiring? Why is it that K-Lab, the Japanese company that makes Bleach Brave Souls, and Crunchyroll can do the correct translation, but you can't? Now, I know people are going to be like, oh, well, what's the big deal? It's only a swear word that got censored out. Yeah, maybe. Let's forget about the fact that it changes all of Nini's demeanor on her first appearance, technically, if you're not counting Chapter 0 from the one-shot. In the translation, Nini actually says, fairy tales are bullshit, aren't they? Whether it's a question, when it's not a question, it's actually a statement, because Nini actually says fairy tales are bullshit. And that's a statement. It shows a character. This is what she believes in. This is her world view on life. However, Viz's translation actually makes it seem like she's questioning it and she's not so certain. Or maybe it's rhetorical. I don't know. But the correct translation actually makes her point's pretty much valid and her character pretty much valid from the get-go. Let's talk about the massive spelling mistakes that are in the novel for Bleach as well. Let's talk about the translation issues in the latest Bleach chapter as well, which, again, for example, calling beasts and ghouls something different, even though the beasts are people like Kumamura, so you're going to confuse consistency in regards to that. It's the little things, I understand, but the fact you didn't even change it, like, I get if you were releasing chapters weekly, right, you're going to use a machine to do it, or you're going to get someone to quickly glance over it and do whatever, but when you're doing a volume release, you know, make sure to fucking check that shit, because that's supposed to be the most definitive edition, right? Let's talk about this as well. This is the Japanese version of Burn the Witch, the most definitive version, because clearly you can't fucking translate to save your fucking life. You did a slipcover, and your slipcover is so ass that it fucking breaks on people. And they're paying how much? They're paying close to $20? When isn't a Blue Exorcist volume like more pages and is cheaper than the Burn the Witch volume? Like, make it make sense, Viz. I don't understand how you can fuck up so many times. Let's talk about the Bleach Blu-rays. How is it that you got four of the Blu-rays, or the parts where it's actually 4x3, how is it you got them right? But the moment it goes widescreen, that shit still looks pixelated. It doesn't have any interlacing on it. It doesn't have any anti-aliasing on it. It looks so bad still. It's upscaled. I mean, everyone knows that it's upscaled, but it's upscaled really, really badly. Like, it's not clean, it's not crisp. You went from 4x3 to that, and it looks bad because there's literally no difference between the DVD release and that. Maybe you get more episodes on a disc. Congratulations. It looks ass. And people have called you out on it, and you're not speaking on it. These are people buying your product. We're not trying to be arseholes for the sake of being arseholes. We're not trolling you. We're giving you genuine feedback on your products, yet you still continue to push it out like nothing's the matter. I do not understand what is with this big fucking ego from Crunchyroll and Viz. Like, your products are becoming fucking arse, and you need to fucking sort it out because it's not fucking acceptable. Let's talk about Funimation. I'm not even going to go on to the whole controversy about certain voice actors, which confused the hell out of me why they're still hired. But regardless of that in the first place, why are you trying to monopolize every single anime streaming service? Because there's already a few anime streaming services which have been taken down now in replacement for the Funimation streaming service, which I guess people are going to hit and miss, like or dislike, I don't know, but stop doing it. Like, why do you feel the need to buy every company out? Are you trying to be a monopoly? I don't know if it's Sony, I don't know if it's Aniplex, I don't know if it's you specifically, Funimation, but why do you feel the need to want to buy everyone out? What's going on? And to end my point, Disney are getting involved in the anime industry, and they've recently just bought Summertime Rendering and Black Rock Shooter. People have wanted to know what my thoughts were on Twitter, and my thoughts were, well, I don't like Disney. I will see how Summertime Rendering is going to be animated, and I'm going to see how Black Rock Shooter is animated. Let's see if the censorship, let's see what the profanity is like, let's see how PG or 18 plus it is. Because depending on that, I'm glad that Disney, unironically, even though I don't like them and they might be a necessary evil for you, Crunchyroll, Viz and Funimation, to maybe start sweating a little bit, because maybe you need a big fish to humble you and actually keep your audience. Because if you keep fucking up and Disney keep getting IPs, because instead of you spending money on here's some money for High Guardian Spice, how about you give some money for some IPs instead of letting someone like Disney or Crunchyroll fucking outbuy you, or Funimation outbuy you, or Aniplex or Sentai? You know, put your money into the IPs that people want, because you're gonna have people like Disney pick them up, or Netflix pick them up, and more people are going to go to Disney and Netflix. Why? Because you wanted to fucking waste your money on other shit. Case in point, I hope that what you're doing works out for you guys. I wonder how long people are going to tolerate the bad translations and censorships, because we know you censor your manga too, Viz. Yeah, I wonder how much people will tolerate before they get tired of your company, because this isn't the way to go. You're going to lose a very core, loyal fan base, and blocking them on Twitter isn't resolving anything. Did I deserve it by posting the writers' tweets as a quote tweet? Again, I didn't say any context. I didn't say a word. I just posted her tweets. I posted her tweets. And I got blocked, Crunchyroll. Explain that. Now, did I deserve it? Well, do you know what? I was very, very quiet for years and months on end after you started to re-announce it. That, do you know what? I'm kind of sick to my stomach that you would allow such vile, toxic fucking creatures, not only on your bankroll, but on your site. Disgusting. Again, I've been in controversies And I will own that. But I really don't know how you can defend this. I really don't. It's literally wishing death on a population of males. Like, what? I mean, we'll forget the fact that her tweets have also said that she wants to push an agenda as well. To my viewers and my subscribers, I'm sorry if you don't like this type of video. But you know what? If you ever see High Guardian Spice, don't fucking watch it. Don't even look at it. If you see some shoddy products or mistranslations from Viz, tell them about it. Because it's literally their job to translate. That's literally what their company was founded on. Translating. How'd you fuck up on your main core job? I don't fucking know. I don't fucking know. Hey, and if you think I'm a dickhead and you don't like me, then unfollow all the people or the big AnnieTubers that you follow that made videos on you in the past and keep that same energy. Apart from that, I hope you guys enjoyed the rant and a little time killer. With that being said, I'm going to catch you motherfuckers later. You guys, of course, have this fine Debbie Hansen as always, people.